Okay, children, again welcome back. So already we have discussed about the body parts and the internal body parts we have discussed in the last video. So now let us discuss about the external body parts. The body parts which can be seen outside very easily. What are those body parts? We know that. Hands, we have legs, we have these shoulders, we can see this head part, we can see eyes, we can see nose, we can see ears, we can see teeth, we can see tongue, we can see similarly these fingers we can see, and the toes we can see, the fingers of the feet, and we can see the ankle, knee, and in the leg these all will come. Even we can see the feet, okay, feet and this palm, we can see these all parts. And these are externally present for our body. I mean, these appears external, easily we can see. Then even these are also going to help our body in different many ways. Like, see, I am telling you, in the internal body parts we have discussed about the brain. Then where is the brain? Here is the brain. Then how do the brain is going to be protected? Because of this head, this hard part, this whole head. If it is not there, then we are not at all having brain, we are not at all having eyes, eyebrows, nose. These all are attached to a particular part of body that is known as the head, but it can be seen external. Because of that we call this one will come under the external part of the body. Similarly, the arms, we are doing many more things, many more works, whatever that may be, holding anything, doing some work, writing, reading, doing some work, exercise, playing, or you are doing in the house, any work in the house, outside of the house, or you are playing. You can do many variety of things or many variety of activities only with the help of the arms. Arms means what? These hands. Then without hands, there will be very difficult for us to lead the life. Arms are also very much helpful. Then arms, it is seen just like this. Okay, but inside the arms, we know that inside there are the bones. Here is a joint, here is a joint, isn't it? But bones and muscles have bind together, and this is the layer of the skin which is covered upside, and it totally it is forming an arm, and which can be seen outside. We can see like this, okay? So this is what the help of the arms to our body. Then the feet. If there is no feet, is it possible for me to stand like this? No, it's not possible. Then feet are most important to hold the whole body weight and to make the body to stand straight or tilt or run or walk. The feet are very much important. Then we have the legs. If there is no leg, again it is very difficult for us to assume or guess our life. Because to walk, run, to do our works, to do exercise, to do many more things that may be, of course, playing may be there, exercise may be there, our simple works may be there. If we want to move from one place to another place, legs are most important. If there are no legs, it is not at all possible for us to lead a normal life. The legs are most important for our body. Leg is also considered as the most important part of the body to lead a normal and a happy life. Then how the legs are? We know that. Again, inside the leg, there are the bones and they have joined together. And those bones and muscles are there. And again, it is just like the hand or arms. It is covered with the skin. Okay. And again, feet is attached to the lower part of the leg. And to the feet, the toes are attached. The toes are attached, and even those toes help us to hold the whole body, to give grip to the whole body, or to hold the whole body. Even our toes are also helpful. This is how the legs and the toes are going to help. Even the hands and arms, both are same only. Hands and arms, if there are no hands, there is no normal life we can lead. Because see, if only one hand is not there, I am unable to do my work very easily. Simply, I can't drink water, I can't eat, I can't do my things, because I have to depend on only one hand. No, if I have both the hands, then it's okay. If I have only one hand also, it is very difficult for us to lead the life. this is how the head is also important, arms are also important, feet are also important, legs, hands, toes, fingers are also most important. Just to assume children, if only this much part from here to here, only this much part we have for the hand, then is it possible for us to hold something, to hold spoon, to eat like this, to eat fruits or vegetables or meals, or to hold the glass of water and drinking like this? Is it possible if there are no fingers? No. Then even the fingers are also helping us to hold the things, to do the work. Fingers, toes, legs, hands, arms, head, these all are external part of the body. Even though these all are external part of the body, they look very simple, but without them there is no normal life we can lead. Children, I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in this video. It's very simple, and along with that simplicity, it's very important also. Then before winding this video, I would like to give you a homework. Just explain about external parts of the body. How do you are going to explain? What is the role of the head? What is the role of the arms? What is the role of the feet? What is the role of the legs and hands? You are going to explain. I hope you will do this homework, and let us meet in the next video with the next new topic. Till then, keep studying, keep reading, keep doing whatever the homework is given in this video, and be happy. Let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.